Good evening. I've been painting this painting. This is my fourth Formula One painting of the 60 here. And I've been painting this afternoon. Okay, this too full. All right, let me just put this away. Oh, this, the other one is here. Okay, so as I was saying, I've been painting this 60 era painting. And I've done some different colors, tones. Now I'm going to put the white. Let me just put the white. A little brush here to put the white on this. I put this type because it makes it very easy to make a straight line for the circuit. You know, when you're doing things like that, instead of making, you know, it's going to be nice and straight. Okay, let me see if this one is the brush that I want, or it could be that it's not. Maybe it's too soft. I think maybe I'm going to try the other brush. Let me see. Not this one. I think it's this one. That's the one. It's a bit hard. It's no point in making hard work for yourself. When you don't need to, it's no point in making hard work. Oh, it's this one, not this one. This one goes here, and this is the one. Okay. So let me just get the white again. And it's quite simple. We just go over it, doesn't matter. Look, just go like that. Go like that. That way you don't need to worry about being in a straight line, you know, your brush is going a bit too thin, doesn't matter. Okay, see? That's simple. And then in here. The same in here. The same in here. Let me just put this thing cleaned. Okay, let me just do this here. Wait a minute. Let me just get this the other color. Okay, there's the other color. Now I'm going to show you. I'm going to put a bit more green on the car here with my ink pens I usually use. I'll show you. And I'm going to explain to you how they work. It's very simple. What you do, you go in the area that you want to make it dark. You go here. Let's say here. Can you see? And the part that you'll make it dark, you just go like that quite a lot. Look like this. It goes over, 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 it gets it darker. Like here, look. Can you see how dark it is there? And then leave the other bit of dark light. Okay? And for the red in here, it's the same. The red one, here, look. This side, you want it dark on this side, so you just go here a lot, look, I guess. Keep on going the same, don't go too much out, just keep on the same area. It gets darker and darker. You don't want too much in here, just slightly look. Just to give a little hint of the color, leave that part there as it is. Can you see? There's these ink pens, beautiful, they are really good. Okay, so now what we're going to do, we're going to use my brown. First we're going to take this off, look, very slightly, very low, slowly, look. Just lift it up like that, look. Just nicely, slowly. Okay, and the same one now coming down. Okay, there's that one. Goes in the paper. And then you pull the other one out. So the same way, look, slowly. Because you don't want to rip the paint. Because the paint is painted in heavy watercolor paper, but you don't want to pull it too strong and rip the paint out. Otherwise, you have to paint it up again. See, look. See, nice and straight. Look at that. Beautiful, isn't it? Very simple. It makes it your work easier. That's all it is. And the same goes in the side now. Look, the same way, very slowly. Pull it out. Okay, the same way, the other way, this one is done, and then this one here, this one slowly. Can you see, look at that, how simple, how good that is, it's a nice line, it looks like it's been painted today. And now I'm going to show you, you're going to put some dark areas in here. Brush is still wet with white, so let me just everything fell in top of the paint. Incredible. It could have fallen somewhere else, but no, in top of the paint. Oh, you still got some paint here. And now you just go some areas here, look. You see? And you build it up as you want, as it dries, and you add some other colors. You know, it's nobody rushing you. In here, nobody's rushing you. Nobody say, oh, hurry up, hurry up. So, you know. And let me put some music and then let this bit dry. And then we'll see what we're going to do next. So let's put some music. I started doing this one in the afternoon. I've done quite a bit of it, and then the woman next door, I was taping, and then the woman next door starts talking. She talks so much, she just talks silly talk. Always talking about other people and, I don't know, silly. You know, nothing to do. So then I thought, well, I don't know if he affected the taping. So anyway, I have this one I'm doing a bit more colors to it. I was just waiting a bit to dry. But can you see how easy it is in there? When you put it in there, and then later on I'm going to put paint also. Because with this one I can take as long as I want, I can take a couple of months. 6 months, doesn't matter. Some areas I think, well, I'm going to put more texture, you can just go along. I've got a few paintings that I'm doing that. So at the end, when you finish, it's really a lot of texture and nice. It might take 2-3 months, I don't know. And I've got, tomorrow, I've got two paintings that the people, one is karting, and one another one is like a sports car. The persons, they liked it, they said they liked it, and it's been about 5-6 months. They have never got in touch with me back, so I don't think they're going to buy it, so there's no point, you know, losing space, because I don't have a lot of space to hold paintings. So tomorrow I'm going to paint abstract paint on top of that. So if they want, that's it, then. You know, this is why it's important for people, if they like the painting, to get sorted out. I mean, I can hold them for 3-4 months, but that's it. This used to be in about 6 months. I sold 10 of them, different people, in the same time other than them. They was quite quick and they just got their painting, that's it. But some people, they take too long, I don't know. I don't know if they lose my details. Anyway, tomorrow I'm going to paint abstract art and then advertise for it as an abstract art painting. Because the boards are good, you know, I'm not going to waste boards. Because they're special boards. Some I make, you know, I buy some watercolor heavy paper. And then I make the board myself very strong. Others, I buy it already. Sometimes if they don't have, I have to make my own. But I'm used to it, to make it so. I didn't want this in Spanish, but anyway. I wanted some English music, but look. Can you see Westerns in Spanish? What's happening here? I mean, it's all right for the Mexicans. I mean, I can understand a bit of Spanish. I got a friend I teach to paint. He's Spanish, so you'll be understanding that. I haven't seen him for quite a bit of time now because of this, since this coronavirus. I haven't really seen him. He does mini cap. I don't know if he's too busy, I haven't heard from him. I leave that as it is, let it dry. See, it doesn't matter what colors you put, because whatever colors you put, then you're going to add different colors, so it doesn't matter at the beginning. At the beginning you can put any color, it doesn't matter really what it is. I like this part here, like early, you know, early morning. They're already practicing, imagine that. So it looks quite nice. I still have to put spectators in here and in there. Bits and pieces really. The lines in there I have to do, a little bit of line there. Then maybe some grass. This part here, I'm going to leave it like that because it's like, it's far away, so you don't really want a lot of detail. So you just turn a bit of a wash and I leave it. I think it looks quite good. I like the clouds also, the clouds look nice. Skies are quite difficult to do because you never do the same. You can do a sky and you'll never do the same one again.